timbers.
15 men on a dead man's chest.
Armed.
Pirates. People have always been enamored with pirates.
Maybe it's the perennial appeal of the bad boy.
Or bad girl.
Image.
Maybe it's the romantic picture of mysterious schooners following the Jolly Roger on the Spanish Main.
Maybe it's the allure of tropical islands and treasure chests brimming with gold and silver.
Maybe it's the cute outfits that they wear, with striped pants, puffy shirts, and rakish black eye patches.
Every year, the number one selling costume for Halloween is a pirate costume.
Books, movies, toys, and video games have all jumped on the pirate bandwagon. Or ship, I guess you'd say.
There's even a national talk like a pirate day.
Pirates are in.
Pirates are popular.
There's just no getting around it.
The show you are about to see is a shameless attempt to capitalize on this pirate phenomenon.
The playwright could have chosen any number of topics. Topics more praiseworthy and more original, but let's face it. All of you out there came to see a pirate play.
Would you have come to see a dissertation on the effects of aerosol sprays on the ozone layer?
Where are you both going?
To see the Fearsome Pirate Frank show.
He's like so adorable.
I love when he says a vasty lily-livered Bildrax.
Or when he calls all the girls me finally wenches.
Oh my gosh, wenches. I love when he calls us wenches.
We rest our case.
Yo, ho, ho. To Davy Jones Locker we go. Ho, ho. Yo, ho, ho.
The Adventures of the Fearsome Pirate Frank.
Part the first.
Arr! Yo, ho, ho. Yo, ho, ho. We be doing a pirate show. Ho, ho. Yo, ho, ho. Yo, ho, ho.
The original Fearsome Pirate Frank wasn't really a pirate, you know.
He was an actor back in the days of old William Shakespeare.
Frank was a pretty good actor.
He could strike a noble pose.
He could convey comedy.
Interesting. With the best of them.
He did have one major flaw, though.
No matter how hard he tried, poor Frank just could not remember his lines.
To be or not to be?
Is that the question?
This made directors very angry.
No! 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 To be or not to be? That is the question.
That's what I asked. Is that the question?
Not is that the question. That is the question.
But if the question is...
No, you know what? I stand enough. Get out. Get out. Get out.
It made other actors angry, too.
One night, Frank was playing opposite the world-famous actress Esmeralda Effington.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Romeo!
Get thee to a nunnery!
Get thee to a nunnery? Get thee to a nunnery? You've got the wrong play, you moron! I will never work with that fool again!
Poor Frank. And he had quite a crush on Esmeralda, too.
Audiences weren't very patient with Frank either.
Tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow, and maybe yesterday, creeps into this pretty place, and
boo!
Obviously, Frank wasn't going to make it as a great Shakespearean actor.
He was in luck, though, because just about the time he was thinking of chucking the whole thing and becoming a chimney sweep, he was taken on by an agent who knew just what type of part fit Frank to a T. His name was Mr. Smee. I wonder where our playwright got that name.
I'll tell you, Frank, this is the part for you.
Really?
Sure. There is no stuffed shirt directors or temperamental actresses to do with it. All you have to do is a fierce and daring with a sword and eye patch, and you've got it made.
I can look fierce and daring.
Of course you can. And best of all, there is no complicated lines to learn. When you can't think what to say, just say R.
R.
A little deeper.
R.
Let it come from your throat.
R.
No gusto.
R.
By George, I think you got it.
R.
And so Frank became the lead in a new hit show that was taking the town by storm.
And he became the fearsome pirate Frank.
Sound the alarm! Sound the alarm!
It's the fearsome pirate Frank.
The ship is just laid anchor.
Close your windows and doors.
Lock up your gold and silver.
Hide your tools and heirlooms.
You'll feel the rug from under your feet.
Oh, you'll be very near to your desk rather than
gangway,
me fuckers!
Gangway!
Hold your tongue, you lovers!
Or we be holding up for ya.
The fearsome pirate Frank has something to say, and he be ready to say it.
Quiet, everyone, quiet!
The fearsome pirate Frank is going to speak. What do you want, oh fearsome pirate Frank?
We are but simple villagers.
But we will try to meet your demands.
I be wanting
yes.
I be wanting
yes.
Arr!
Arr!
Attendance topped Shakespeare's stuff by a mile.
Which I think says something about the taste of the Elizabethan public.
Frank and his band of pirates were instant celebrities, accosted everywhere they went by screaming wenches desperate to get an autograph or steal a piece of pirate paraphernalia.
Do we have your autograph?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, it was a glorious time for Frank. He had become a star.
And he'd even got to work with Esmeralda Effington again.
Frank, what do you think of this new costume I have for the Pirate Queen?
Zelda, you are a vision in velvet. You are. You look. Arr!
Arr? What's that supposed to mean? You do think I look fat! You think I look like a fat pig, don't you? Say it!
No, no, Esmeralda, I
know it's what you think!
No, no.
Ouch.
Anyway, Frank had become rich.
He'd become famous.
What more could he ask for?
Here are the receipts for last night's show, Frank. This card gig's an absolute goldmine. Who would have ever thought people would love pirates so much?
I don't know, Smee. I'm getting a bit tired of saying "Arr!" every night. It's doing quite strange things to my vocal cords.
Maybe you should add in a few more "Oys" and "Avasts." You're really good at those lines, too.
True. And my "There she blows" was quite successful last night. But it's more than the lines, Smee. Something is missing in my life. I feel incomplete in a way, dissatisfied.
Would you believe it? An introspective pirate. There may be more to Frank than meets the eye.
I think what I need is a fine, big, liverwurst sandwich.
Then again, maybe not.
To get on with our story, Frank and his fellow actors were in the midst of their crew when they had some unexpected visitors. Nice touch, the music, don't you think?
It was Act Two, and Frank had just met up with his arch nemesis, the Pirate Queen, played, of course, by that one-time Shakespearean sensation and head smacker extraordinaire, Esmeralda Effington.
Who gave you leave to come ashore on the island of the Pirate Queen?
I need no man to give me leave, Pirate Queen. I be the fearsome Pirate Frank. I ask leave of no man.
The fearsome Pirate Frank? Who be the fearsome Pirate Frank?
Who said that?
It came out there from the audience. You can just ignore it.
You may ask leave of no man, young pirate, but if you value your life, you'd better ask leave of me, the Pirate Queen.
Skipper be dipper, the white command and she be a queen.
Ye up! Ye up! Arr! Arr! All right. Ye may be a queen, me beauty. But I be the fearsome Pirate Frank, king of all the pirates.
Now you're trying patiently, laddie. Come on, mates. It'd be time to set the record straight. Ye ain't the fearsome Pirate Frank. Ye and your mates be just a bunch of lily-livered landlubbers pretending to be pirates.
Lovers they be, all right, Captain. They ain't never set foot on a pirate ship before, that be sure.
Look at this wee cutlass, little girl.
Aw, ain't it sweet? Give that back! Get it back!
They be bending like willow on a riverbank.
And they be wearing wigs like fine, pretty wenches.
That was really rude!
And what do ye have to say for yourself, fearsome Frank? What be the matter? Cat got your tongue?
Well, arr!
Arr! The little bilge up, he's saying arr!
Arr! I think a frog be jumping in his throat.
Or he be choking on a sea slug.
And this weed of pirate here, she be just a silly wee wench, thinking a great lot of herself.
That is enough! Get off my stage this instant! I shall not have my scene ruined by some low-life women dressed as filthy scoundrels.
Low-life women? Filthy scoundrels? You hear that, mates? She be sullying our reputations. Watch your tongue, lassie, or I be introducing ye to that cat o' nine tails.
Aye, the cat.
Let's give her the cat.
Frank, do something. Get these women who have never heard of bath powder.
press charges.
Leave. Leave, he says. I be leaving when I be good and ready, you scurvy dog. And when I do, I think I be taking one of ye with me. Grab the wench. By the look of her, I be thinking we be getting a fine fat ransom for the lassie.
No, let her go! What be ye saying, matey?
I mean, please, let her go.
Ooh, what be the matter, young squiffies? Afraid of you sharp cusses, held by some weak, wee women. Tie them up, bones. I think we be bringing them too. They'll always be used for a few extra hands to swab the decks and clean out the bilges.
Aye, aye, Captain. Squish together, ye little fishies. We be claiming our tiny time.
Let go of me! Let go!
Blimey, she be a right saucy wench.
How dare you? Who do you think you are accosting us like this?
Who do I think I be? Well, I be telling ye, little lass. I be the fearsome pirate Frank. The real fearsome pirate Frank.
Blimey, the pirate Frank's a woman.
And a vicious one at that.
Oh, dear.
Smartly, me mates. Right smartly. Let's get these young scrogs to the ship.
You heard, Captain. Get with any scurvy outfits.
Oh, no. I don't think I like what's happening here.
I'm gonna call my agent.
Me too, this was not in my contract.
What's an addle pate?
Ow, you're pinching my arm.
Hold your tongues, you bill-sucking blackguards. One of you mateys will hold them for you.
Arr!
Yo, ho-ho, yo, ho-ho, to Davy Jones Locker we go, ho-ho, yo, ho-ho, yo, ho-ho.
The Adventures of the Fearsome Pirate Frank.
Part the second.
Arr!
Yo, ho-ho, yo, ho-ho, we be doing a pirate show, ho-ho. Yo, ho-ho, yo, ho-ho.
Poor Frank and his fellow actors. They never plan on being shanghaied onto a real pirate ship when they sign up for this gig.
Let alone a pirate ship run by a bunch of women.
Keep in mind that women did not have equal rights back in the Elizabethan era, and female pirate was beyond reproach. Anyway, the ship sailed at dawn, and the cast of the Fearsome Pirate Frank show was put to work swabbing the decks, pumping the bilges, and, well, whatever other lowly thing there is to do on a pirate ship.
Esmeralda was kept in a small cabin below decks, which, if you ask me, was a very wise choice on the part of Captain Frank.
Look at them lounging around up there while we do all the work.
This is so embarrassing. Being shanghaied by a bunch of women?
They're not ordinary women. Look at them.
Shut your traps down there and keep swabbing them decks. Or I'll be having you key hauled for dawn.
Yes, sir. Ma'am.
This is outrageous. Completely outrageous.
I tried to be keeping her in the cabin, Captain, but she'd be running out as soon as I turn my back.
I refuse to be kept in that filthy place.
Are ye telling me, lassie, that ye not be happy with your accommodations?
Accommodations? You can hardly call that smelly, rat-infested sinkhole accommodations. There's no place to take a bath. I haven't been able to wash my hair. And you kidnapped me without even allowing me to bring my makeup case.
Well, sink me. She ain't got her makeup case. Better be throwing her the jolly buzz in her own.
Esmeralda, you might want
to
try.
Don't even speak to me, you spineless imbecile. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't even be here.
By the powers, listen to that saucy lass.
Aye, she be a rum one, all right.
You be talking true, mates. We may be needing to scupper her. She be keeping it up.
Scupper her? What does that mean?
I don't know, but it can't be good.
But you're a woman, too. You must understand my needs.
I understand. You need to shut your trap. Little now.
Aye, Captain.
Get her down below. I'm not been liking a wench like her up on decks. Be silly in the name of us female buccaneers.
Aye, aye, Captain. Come on, lassie. You're not getting away from me this time. You haven't heard the end of this. I was Rob Effington. A star. Let go.
I'm not sure the captain knows what she's getting into with Esmeralda.
It's not Esmeralda's fault.
She's just a bit high-strung, that's all.
And what be ye doing? Stay- on vacation. Betty Bones!
Hi, Captain!
See these scrogs. They not seem to be understanding the meaning of hard work.
Aye, aye, Captain. Look at this deck, you scabby dogs. I'd be having these swabbing all night if you can't be doing a better job than this.
But Miss Bones, we have been swabbing all night.
It's so clean my grandmother weed off of it.
Then your grandma be a scurvy old wench. Do as I say and keep swabbing. And what be ye looking at, Scrog? Pump that bilge water.
But Miss Bones, look at the pirates up there. They've barely done a lick of work since we boarded this boat.
First of all, this be a ship, a great, grand ship. Don't insult her by calling her a boat. Second of all, ye don't question orders, ye follow them. Now pump that bilge water.
But Miss Bones, I have another concern about this entire enterprise. This bilge water, as you call it, is quite filthy. I wouldn't imagine that it is teeming rats. I think it is extremely irresponsible of you to ask us to stand it like this.
I agree. Who knows what kind of harmful diseases we're being exposed to?
Not to mention the rats. This boat, I mean ship, is quite infested with them. I really think you should call an exterminator.
An exterminator, you say? Hear that, Captain Frank? The wee scrog here thinks we should be calling an exterminator.
An exterminator? An exterminator? Watch your tongue, bucko. The only exterminating done on the ship be by me. And I don't waste my time on furry little rats.
Well, I was only pointing out that—
Hold your tongue, you bucko. The likes of ye don't be pointing out things to the likes of me. Ye and that troublesome wench don't seem to understand your situation here. Don't yer know whose ship this be? Don't yer know who I be?
Well, you're the captain, I know, but—
Belay the butts, you blackguard. I told you before. I be the fearsome pirate Frank, the terror of the high seas. I ain't no fancy actor pretending to be a pirate. Open your dead legs, matey. Woman I may be, but I be the real thing. The toughest, the meanest, the nastiest captain to sail the Jolly Roger. I be a pillaging pirate, nasty, mean, assault. I've fed the fish with many a man, but blimey, that ain't me fault.
Her fault!
I'll give the black spot to you, cause dead men tell no tales. I'll send you to the fiddler's green, then I'll hoist me sails.
And then she'll hoist her sails.
I be the pirate Frank,
the fearsome pirate Frank.
And many a man has washed the plank because he's messed with Frank.
Don't mess with Frank.
Booty is me calling, silver and doubloons, and any blackguard that crosses me will find himself marooned.
Maroon.
I use the cat o' nine tails to send to the briny deep. The scurvy scrub that steals me swag, I'll make his widow weep.
Sure, make his widow weep.
I be the pirate Frank,
the fearsome pirate Frank.
And many a man has walked the plank because he's messed with Frank.
Don't mess with Frank.
I be a pillaging pirate, a nasty, mean old salt. I've fed the fish with many a man, but blimey, that ain't me fault.
Her fault.
I'll give the black spot to ya, cause dead men tell no tales. I'll send you to the fiddler's green, and then I'll hoist me sails.
And then she'll hoist her sails.
I be the pirate Frank,
the fearsome pirate Frank.
And many a man has walked the plank because he's messed with Frank. And many a man has walked the plank because he's messed with Frank. Don't mess with Frank!
Sail ho, Captain! Sail ho! I spy me a ship on the starboard sea!
A ship, you say? See to it, Bones. We may be having some swags to be collected.
Aye, aye, Captain. It be a ship, all right, Captain. It be the zombie ship, the Black Mark.
The Black Mark?
The Black Mark!
Begad, come about, come about!
Come about,
come about!
Blimey, we be in for it. If we don't upsail the blackguard, we be feeding the fishies with our fine carcasses.
Man, the haywire!
Drop the fishies!
Reach the guy, Bobber!
You scrubs over there, batten down!
Captain Frank and her crew raced across the sea all day, all night, and all the next day trying to outrun the zombie ship.
Finally, just as the sun was beginning to set on the second night, they seemed to have lost her.
I think she's gone, Captain. There be no sign of her on the horizon.
Thank the powers.
That was the most exhilarating experience I've ever had. The excitement of the chase, the feel of the wind on my face.
You, Frank, are an idiot.
I feel like every bone in my entire body has been crushed into mush.
Me too. Every time the ship pounded down a wave, I wanted to scream.
I think I'm going sick.
Should I put a mate on watch when we camp it and let the others get some sleep?
Aye, Betty. We be wanting them fresh if the Black Mark shows herself again.
Aye. Old Tilly Tar, ye be keeping watch with me. The rest of ye, man the sheets and halyards and down to your bunks to get some shut-eye.
Aye, Bones.
I be in me cabin if ye be need me. Send this grog to the deck for some sleep, too. We may be needing him to help with the sails when this boy has to be done. And get that troublesome wench down below. I not be understanding why she not be staying where we be putting her.
Ye heard the captain. Below decks we go so ye can finally be of some use tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am, Miss Bones. Below decks we go. We're on our way. Post days as it were.
And what be ye two still standing around for?
I have no intention of going back down there again. It's rancid, filthy, and smells like vomit.
Listen here, lassie. I not be wanting to tie you to the gunwales for a flogging, but ye be tempting me mighty.
Please excuse Esmeralda.
You have to remember, we're just lowly actors, unaccustomed to the rigors of the pirating life.
Lowly actors? Speak for yourself, Frank. I am no lowly actor. I am a star, and I expect to be treated as such.
Take no stars on this ocean, lassie, except the stars in the sky. I be suggesting you get yourself down below, or I be having one of me mateys carry you down.
You wouldn't dare.
Little Nell, One-Eye Joan, Hillary Hook, grab the wench.
Aye,
get away from me, get away.
I'm already down. Ah! Put me down! I am Esmeralda Effington, a star, queen of the theater. Put me down!
Got be your right-spirited young wench, Bones. She be that, old Tilly. She be that. And what be ye still standing around for, Scrog?
Well, I was wondering if I
out with it, Swabby, ye be wasting me time!
Well, I was wondering if maybe I could remain on watch with you and Miss Tillytown. I could be of some help, you know, do whatever you do on watch.
Ye wanna help, eh?
It not be a bad idea to have an extra set of eyes tonight, mate.
I guess ain't no harm in it. Ye can stay so long as you don't get in our way.
Thank you, Miss Bones. I won't be in the way, I promise.
Either Frank is really taking the pirate life, or he has something up his sleeve.
Which I highly doubt. I don't think he's clever like that.
Nothing out there, Miss Bones. It's a really nice spyglass, Miss Bones. Much better than the one I used in the play.
Of course is. I got it from me great-grandpa, for he danced with old Jack Ketch.
Jack Ketch? Was he a pirate too?
Ha! Be Jack Ketch a pirate too?
Blimey, that was a good one.
Jack Ketch be the hangman, me young swab. Many a pirate be dancing with him for their life be through.
Aye, either that or be finding a bunk in Davy Jones' locker.
Oh, I guess I don't know a lot about being a pirate. My acting coach always told me to research my parts, but I just never had the time. It always took me such a long time to learn my lines.
Turn a bit to port, old Tilly. We be wanting to catch more of that southeasterly wind.
Aye, may this fair wind be taking us further away from that blasted zombie ship.
Zombie ship?
It's not full of real zombies, is it?
Captain Frank seemed especially upset by it.
Not full of real zombies? Shiver me timbers, lad, where you been all your life? Did Black Mark be the bane of every jack that sails the sea?
And it especially be the bane of our own Captain Frank!
Aye, the Black Mark be following her ever since she done the deed it has.
Done the deed? What do you mean?
That be for Betty Bone to tell you, lad. She's been there from the very start. I just come in for the finale. What say you, Bones? You be wanting to tell the lad the tale?
Begad! Why not, old Tilly? Sit yourself down, laddie. It be a long story, but we be having a long night. I was just a young swab at the time, and best friend to Captain Frank. Our father was the captain of the Beetaloo, a five-fast sloop bound for the Barbary Coast.
In order to milk this piratey play to the fullest, the playwright has decided to insert a flashback here.
It provides the opportunity for more action, more swashbuckling, and more pirates, which of course is what every pirate aficionado wants.
Therefore, imagine yourself, cast back in time to the days of Betty Bones' tale, to the days of the Vitaloo.
Captain Frank's father died on the Vitaloo, and old Ben Davies took over as captain. He were the meanest old sea dog would ever walk the deck of a sailing ship.
Belay that talk, ye swabs, or I be hanging ye by your thumbs to the bowsprit.
Sorry, Captain. We be just about to see to the bat you're in.
It be rotten away, Captain, and the sails be chafing.
Then be doing it, buckos, and right smartly, too, if you know it's good for ye.
No! 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 No!
Here be the pillage drop that be given into the doubloons, Captain. Keel haul the blackguards, then feed them to the fishes.
Oh, no, please, Captain, please. I be doing it for me poor mother. I be giving her to loot to keep her from the poor house. No! 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 Aye, Ben Davies were a mean old dog, all right. And he were the meanest of the women on board. Me and Frank. Couldn't get rid of us, though. Because he had made up Frank's dad a promise when he were on his deathbed. Frank's dad had always wanted a son, ye see, to carry in his footsteps as a pirate. That be why he named his daughter Frank. He made old Ben promise to train Frank in the buccaneering ways. After all, he, unlike most folks, believed in the natural abilities of women. A promise he kept sacred in the pirate code. So Ben had to keep us. He didn't have to be nice to us, though. Soon as Frank's dad passed away, he put us to work doing the lowest, dirtiest jobs even a scurvy bilge rat would turn its nose at.
Get down in that head, swabby, and clean out all the scum you find in there. I want sparkling here, sparkling! And what be ye looking at, Scrog? Get down in that bilge water and strain out all that molten seagrass.
It stuck in Ben's craw, Rydell. To have two women on board?
And most of the crew felt the same. There weren't many women pirating back in them days. Most of the tars thought it'd be bad luck to have a female on board. With Frank's father gone, there weren't no one to stand up for us, but Ben be blaming us for everything that went wrong.
You know why we missed out on that chase, you old fool wenchie? We missed out on that fine, fat swag, because you deny y'all to port when I be telling you.
But Captain, you be telling her to sail the starboard.
Hold your tongue, you scurvy wench. You not be calling me a liar.
Ye ain't no liar, Captain. I be hearing you telling her to yacht port.
I were to hear it too. Yacht port, you said?
That's what comes of having a wench on board, Captain. She don't know port from starboard.
Hold your tongues, ye dogs, or I be holding them for ye!
Every day Captain Frank be spending under Captain Ben Davies, we're to bring the day of reckoning one day near. She began to plot and to plan. She began to plan mutiny, ye see. One night when we set ashore in the port of Cape Town, she brought on board a crew of the toughest, the meanest women pirates would ever walk the deck of a sailing ship. One Eye Joe, Little Nell, Hillary Hook, and Tilly Tar. Them four and me and Captain Frank be taking over the crew while they be sleeping. Old Ben were right surprised when he be waking up the next morning.
What be the mean of this? Who be these wenches with their cutlasses drawn?
They be me crew, Ben. The crew that answers to me is captain.
A crew of women? Ha, disarm them, mates. Take them down.
We would, Captain, but we'd be a bit tied up right now.
They came upon us while we was asleep, Captain.
We never had a chance.
Never had a chance against we wenches? What a scurvy lot ye be.
But, Captain, these wenches be vastly underestimated. They be right mean and vicious.
They be talking true, old Ben. We be mean and vicious. And we be meaning to take over this ship.
Never! No scurvy wenches be taken over my ship.
What What do you be saying about scurvy wenches, Ben?
I think this old dog be asking me to take a walk on our plank.
Aye, it'd be a nice day for walking.
What say ye, mates? Do you want to see your captain walk the plank, or would you rather do it for him?
If I be choosing between him and me, I be choosing the captain to do the walking.
Ye mutinous dog!
What about the rest of ye mates? Do ye want to see your captain walk the plank?
I never really liked the captain.
Me neither.
Make him walk the plank is what I say.
Better him than us.
Make him walk.
Walk the plank! Walk the plank!
Ye heard the mates, old Ben. It be time for ye to feed the sharky. And say hello to the inside of Davy Jones' locker. Onto the plank with him.
This not be the end, wench. I be back. I be back to haunt ye.
Get away from me, ye blagger.
There. I give the black spot to ye. Ye be marked now, aye, because of the black deed ye done today. Blackmore!
In the interest of any children out there in the audience, I would like to state that no actors were hurt during the performance of that scene.
When Captain Ben walked the plank, he did not fall into the ocean to feed the sharks.
In fact, in accordance with Actors Union Code 386, a soft mattress was placed beneath the plank to cushion his fall.
Now, back to our story. Dawn was breaking by the time Bones had finished her tale.
So the zombie ship Blackmark is helmed by the ghost of Captain Ben Davies?
Aye. Captain Frank took over the helm, fired the old Beetaloo pirates, and hired out all women pirates who would help during the deed. She went on to make a name for herself as the most fearsome pirate would ever set the bound in Maine.
Aye. Many stories were told about the captain's adventures.
And every Jolly Roger would be ready to sink from sheer fright.
Except for the black mark. If he sighed on the sea, following us exactly 1 year after the bloody deed.
My word, that is quite an incredible tale. No wonder Captain Frank is so absurd by this black mark ship.
Look at you, consorting with pirates, listening to their drivel.
Esmeralda!
Watch yourself, mate. She be young with the belaying pin.
Esmeralda,
don't talk to me, you traitor.
Now listen, lassie.
Listen yourself. I've had it with you women pirates. Just look at you. You're a disgrace to all womanhood. Why, you haven't even learned to use a proper conditioner on your hair.
Grab the wench. Tilly and Betty seem to be a mite under the weather just now.
Aye, aye, Captain. Watch yourself now. Sheep your tail with that thing.
Listen, lassie. We just...
Ow! That hurt.
I'll be taking care of this, Captain.
Now you be wench. If you would just...
Hi-ya!
Lay down your weapon.
Ye hard, Hillary Hook. Lay down your...
Don't come near me. I have now... not had a bath for over a week. My hair is so filthy, I can feel the lice scurrying around in it, and I do not have one nail left on my hand that is not broken and defiled. I have been pushed beyond endurance on this ghastly ship, and I shall take it no more. Do you hear me? No more.
Blimey, the wench be gone barney. Come on, me mates. We need to disarm her. Circle around her now. Work together.
Get away from me. I'm warning you. I'm warning you.
Esmeralda asks, why is them staying there, enthralled, unable to function in their piratey fashion?
It's because of the sirens, mateys, the song of the sirens.
They've been the scourge of sailors from the beginning of time.
And they're often depicted as beautiful mermaids, so, of course, we had to have them in this play.
Mermaids, you know, are as popular as pirates.
They're in.
They sell.
mesmerized.
We've mesmerized them with our song. It happens every time. There isn't a sailor alive, male or female, who can resist us when we sing. It's starting to get a bit tedious, if you want to know the truth. Is that?
Lip gloss? You've got there?
Of course. What do you think? Coral frost. I used to use sea foam, but it didn't do anything for my complexion.
You've got blush? And you've got a cold?
A wonderful, wonderful cold!
What are you crying about?
I'm sorry. It's just been so long since I've seen a comb and lipstick. Those horrid pirates kidnapped me without my makeup case and...
Kidnapped you without your makeup case?
How dare they? Kidnapping is one thing, but depriving a woman of her foundation and mascara is inexcusable.
Despicable! I know. And without moisturizer, my skin has become dry and flaky. My complexion is blotchy, and my hair is a rat's nest.
You would never know it to look at me, but I was a beauty, yes, something to see. A queen of the stage with fortune and fame. The audience cheered when they called out my name.
The audience cheered when they called out your name.
Then came this pirate and her vile crew to take me away from all that I knew. They were so low, so evil, so base. They even refused me my makeup case.
They even refused you your makeup case.
I have not had a bath in so very long, or a nice shampoo, and that is just wrong. I miss the lotion I used every day, and all those products that make life okay. I dream at night of my makeup case, full of nice things to put on my face.
It's really pathetic to have no cosmetics.
Where is my makeup case? Mascara, lip gloss, and perfume. Foundation, some blush, and shampoo. Lovely nail polish in pink and in blue.
Lotion, eyeliner, a brush, and comb too.
A hint of blue shadow on my lids
made you look sultry.
I know it did, and there's nothing so soothing, I'm sure,
than a long and relaxing manicure.
The feel of mascara on my lash, a touch of perfume,
just a dash,
lining my lips with subtle peach tones,
applying blush to show higher cheekbones.
I dream at night of my makeup case, full of nice things to put on my face.
You can wax so poetic for every cosmetic.
Where is my makeup case?
It feels so frenetic since you lost your cosmetic.
Yes, every cosmetic in my makeup case.
Your dear makeup case.
I want it back.
To look look at them.
They must be made aware of the responsibility that all women bear. They must be taught to face the world strong and brave.
They must learn the merits of choosing the right shampoo and conditioner, of using moisturizer and a good foundation. There is so much for them to learn.
And you shall be their teacher.
Me? You want me to turn those woeful wretches into presentable women armed with mascara, lip gloss, and a subtle blush?
What better teacher than a poor woman who has been victimized by these ignorant pirates who don't even have the sense to protect their faces from the damaging effects of sun and wind?
We shall cast a spell on them to make them putty in your hands. They will beg you to bestow upon them the knowledge of Sephora and Maybelline.
But before we do that, we'll give you
a makeover!
A makeover! Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you!
Shouldn't be thinking.
That's not a very nice thing to say.
Look what you did. You hurt his feelings. Just because you think you're the big deal narrator, you think it's alright to hurt other people's feelings.
That's right. You owe him an apology, Mr. Big Deal Narrator.
Alright, I'm sorry. Now get off the stage. We've got to get on with the play.
Alright. But that apology didn't sound very sincere.
That is what happens when you hire non-equity actors.
Anyway, the sirens were true to their word. They gave Esmeralda a makeover and passed a spell over the living pirates, who made them give a good shampoo and facial.
Esmeralda had the time of her life fixing their hair and faces.
The sirens had left her with a good supply of cosmetics, so she was able to work wonders on the spellbound pirates.
But the next morning, Frank and his fellow actors were shocked by the change in the pirate crew.
Do you like the color of this eyeshadow for little Nell, Frank?
Yes, Esmeralda. It's very nice.
Maybe I should have gone for a deeper red to bring out the color of her eyes.
I don't get this.
Me neither.
I was contemplating on adding some lace in the eye patch, Esmeralda. What do you think?
That might look a bit tacky, Joan. I suggest just using a fine black silk. Sleek and sophisticated is the look you should go for, I think.
Sleek and sophisticated? Fortnite Joan, who are you kidding?
Shut your trap, Swab, and get to work. We've been meeting the enemy left.
Yes, ma'am. Right, ma'am.
Esmeralda, will you be showing me how this mascara thing we work in?
Of course, Nell.
How did Esmeralda get to be in so demand all of a sudden?
It's something that happened last night. I'm not quite sure what it was, but I woke up from some kind of trance or something, and all the women pirates were asking, oh no, pleading with Esmeralda on how to put on a proper base. It was quite strange.
Be getting yourselves ready, all ye swabs and jackbars. Captain Frank be about to unveil her new look.
Wonderful. Did she decide to wear that cute outfit I found in the old trunk for her?
That she did, Essie, and it be looking right smart on her.
Andrew,
introducing Captain Frank, the Pirate Queen.
Thank you, Nick. I do be looking right queenly, don't I?
Sail ho! A ship be coming dead ahead!
A ship, you say? Men, sheets, trim the sails! Let's be bringing yon swaggy about!
Men, the sheets, trim the sails!
What's happening? Have they seen the zombie ship again?
No, it's another ship! Look at the flag!
We need to close it in, Captain.
Grab your cutlasses, mates! We've got ready to board!
Aye, Captain.
Oh, no. I don't think I like what's happening here.
They may have a new look, but they're still the same old pirates.
Those cutlasses are very sharp. They're not for ye, Squall, but for the swab on the other ship.
Let's be boarding her!
Watch how fast they swing those cutlasses. Those sailors don't stand a chance.
What are they doing now?
Collecting their plunder, I think.
They're coming back.
Get a load of the stuff they've stolen.
Huge bags of it.
And they're bringing a captive, too.
This be a great grand haul, Captain. That's ragging related to the gunnels.
Aye, it were a rich one, all right. Take a loop down below. We'll be counting it out later tonight.
Aye, Captain.
Now, you wee lad lover, can you be still so we can be taking this bag off your head?
I think you'd be tired, Cap, but you were a lively one, all right.
Lively and rich, me hearties. By the look of his fine clothes, I'd be thinking we'd be getting a goodly ransom for the lover. Unwrap him, mates. Be time for him to see his new home.
Mr. Smee!
Mr. Smee, what are you doing here?
Ye be knowing this here Bill Sucker, young swabs?
He's Mr. Smee.
He was my agent.
And the manager of our show.
And producer of great renown.
Will that be grand? I be knowing ye'd be bringing us a fine fat ransom.
I could bring you more than that, Captain. When I heard you kidnapped the cast of my entire show, it gave me an idea that could make millions. I'll be willing to share some with you if you cooperate and let Frank go too. I've been needing him for this new venture.
I'd be listening, mate.
We have been doing a pirate show. It was successful. Yes, but you saw it. It was an all make-believe. Nothing stays out forever. Nothing except...
Except?
Except real thing.
What be you meaning?
I got this idea of mine to develop a show where the audience really gets to experience life on a pirate ship. They're taken out to sea and live the true pirate life for a week or a month. Whatever. That's why I was on that ship doing research.
Research?
He'd be a bit balmy, Captain, don't you think? Crazy as a loon.
No, Captain. This is work. I know it. We can even build suspense by having a vote now and then, where the loser walks the plank. I'm thinking of calling it, get this, a reality show.
A reality show? Listen, ye largemouth scallywag. Scupper your slippy show. I'll be taking you to port and collecting a fine, fat ransom for you. And I'll be giving this grog over here to work on me ship. Little now.
Aye, Captain.
Trim the sails. You'll be wanting to catch this fair wind while you're blowing.
Aye, Captain.
A reality show. Thou ne'er flyest.
The reality show.
That is a really cute outfit that the captain has on. Has she ever done any acting?
Mermaids, and now a reality show? Another shameless milking of pop culture.
Before you know it, we'll have comic book heroes and NASCAR drivers written into the script.
Can y'all tell us where the director of this show is?
We heard they had some openings in the final scene.
What did I tell you?
Get lost, guys. The director is gone for the evening.
Well, gee, you ain't gotta be so rude about it. We should go back there anyway and see if we can find someone to talk to you.
It's worth a try. I really want to be in this show.
Like that would really happen.
Anyway, while Smee was having dreams of producing a reality show, Captain Frank was having dreams of her own. And they weren't about the latest colors and lip gloss.
You wouldn't think a bloodthirsty pirate like the fearsome Captain Frank but of anything resembling a conscience. But the black mark wasn't just following her on the high seas. It was following her in her dreams.
Ever since she'd done the black deed, she had nightmares about Captain Ben coming back to get her.
On the night after capturing Smee, she had an especially bad one.
Show yourself, Ben Davies! I know you'd be there, giving me the black spot. You think I'd be afraid of ye? I'd be afraid of no one. I'd be the fearsome pirate friend. I done ye in, and I'd be proud of it. Show yourself, I say. Show yourself.
I be here all right, Frank. I be here to haunt ye for the mutiny ye done, for the black deed ye done.
Let me explain. I envision a show. Believe me, it's like you can't lose.
Little Nell?
Aye, Captain?
I be trying to have a nightmare here.
Oh, no. Sorry, Captain. We just be going down below.
My apologies, Captain. Never let it be said that Mr. Smee and Sophie could not bear. Carry on.
Are ye ready now?
Aye, get on with it.
I tell ye, Frank. It'd be upset when a good night hunt began in chocolate like that. It'd be breaking the mood of the thing.
Get on with it, I say!
Oh, I see you beginning a mite touchy, I see. That be good, Frank. That be good. You done old Ben wrong, so it'd not be long before you must look him in the eye.
No! No!
Admit what you done to an innocent one. Admit and be telling me why.
I admit nothing, ye hear?
Admit what you done to an innocent one. Admit and be telling me why.
It won't mute me. Ye got what ye deserved.
Beware the zombie ship, Black Mark, Frank. It be coming for you. It be coming.
Let it come, Ben Davies. I be ready to sink it and all the fountains what be on it.
Captain Frank!
I be ready, ye hear? I be ready!
Captain Frank, right up!
Who be ye, ye build sucking dog?
It's me, Captain! You know, the actor you kidnapped?
What be ye doing crawling around the decks in the middle of the night?
I heard you yelling, but...
Yelling? I weren't yelling. Get yourself below, or I show you the enemy rope.
Yes, ma'am.
I sometimes have nightmares, too. I dream that thousands of people are laughing at me for forgetting my lines. It makes me...
Below, I say.
Yes, ma'am.
I be ready, Ben Davies. When the black mark be coming, I be ready.
Phew, that was a creepy scene. By the looks of pirate show, that had a few ghosts. The next scene takes place early the next morning. Captain Frank's ship has a visitor.
Whoa, it's me.
I said, woe is me, woe is me.
Woe is me.
I'll tell you, Frank, this is a surefire hit.
And that is precisely why I should be starring in this show of yours, Smee.
Esmeralda, you're not right for the part. But you, Frank, people already identify as a fearsome pirate, Frank. They knock each other out, trying to get on a ship with you.
I don't know, Smee. My word, a bird! About time someone noticed me. I've been sitting here for hours.
Everyone's sleeping. The pirates were up late partying last night.
I see. Well, I guess they can have some fun while I can. For alas, they are doomed. Doomed.
Are you a seagull?
Does that mean we're near land?
No, I'm not a seagull. I only wish I wasn't one of those carefree creatures.
What are you then?
I, young man, am an albatross. Sad avian of the sea.
An albatross? I've heard of you!
Of course you have. Is there anyone who sails the seas who hasn't heard of the albatross? I'm a millstone around every sailor's neck. A dreaded bird to be shot down without pity. I'm an outcast, a pariah. Oh, woe is me. Woe is me.
Don't cry. Please don't cry. Can't be that bad.
That's easy for you to say. You're not an albatross. Do you not understand what it's like to be shunned and feared and despised?
There is a story
I sadly hit the deck. They slung me right around his neck. It's not easy being an albatross. A sad, sad, sad old albatross. They say I'm sure to bring bad news. To see me gives a man the blues. But I'm really just a simple bird. And just in case you haven't heard, it's not easy being an albatross. If a storm brews way up in the sky, every jackdaw thinks that I brought the wind and the hail. They tore their jib and mizzen sail. Oh, woe is me. It's not easy being an albatross. A sad, sad, sad old albatross. When old salts see me in their sleep, they fall upon their knees and weep, cause they believe I bring bad luck. I wish I had been born a duck. It's not easy being an albatross. Their faulty navigating is yours truly. It's aggravating. Oh, woe is me.
It's not easy being an albatross. A sad, sad, sad old albatross.
They say you're sure to bring bad news.
To see you gives the man the blues.
I'm really just a simple bird, and just in case you haven't heard, it's not easy being an albatross.
A sad, sad, sad old albatross.
It's not easy being an albatross.
Blimey, that trunk of clothes we brought in from spaceship, we had some fine little outfits in it. I'm not being so sure about wearing some of them things, though.
Begad, we'd be having an albatross on board!
Little now, shoo it away from the captain be seeing it!
Shoo, shoo, you blasted bird away with thee!
We not be wanting any your kind on this here ship.
See what I mean? Go ahead, kick me, scream at me, call me names. I expect no less. Woe is me!
We not be doing any kicking and screaming, albatross.
We just want you to be leaving and leaving fast.
Every jackdaw knows you'd be bad luck.
How can you say that? She's just a bird. She can't bring luck, good or bad.
Ye not be known the ways of the sea, Scrog.
She be bad news.
Woe, woe, woe is me. What a sorry life I have been dealt by the fickle hand of fate.
And get those Scrogs cleaning up the galley. What be happening up here, Bones? By the powers, get her off the ship. Off, off.
Aye, Captain, we'll get rid of her.
Whoa, whoa, stop, I know right. I know and I'm not wanted. I just have something to say and then I'll be on my way.
We not be wanting to hear what you have to say, bird.
Of course you don't. No one ever wants to hear what I have to say. But I'm going to say it anyway. There is a dark and eerie ship of doom pursuing you.
The Black Mark.
That is her name. She is coming fast. All on board here shall meet a terrible fate. Only he who is pure of heart can vanquish the dusky denizens of this shadowy ship. Did you notice the clever alliteration I used there? Now, if you'll excuse me, I will make my exit and find another ship where I will not be welcome. Woe, woe, woe is me!
Blimey, Captain, what are we gonna do? When an albatross is speaking, it be speaking truth.
A terrible fate she says we be meeting.
Hold your tongues, mates. I be needing to think.
If I might venture to suggest an idea, Captain.
The captain not be asking for ideas from the likes of ye, Scrog.
I use Bones. I'd be open to any ideas that might hold off that blasted zombie ship.
Well, the Albatross said only he who is pure of heart can vanquish the zombie ships.
Aye, and that not be me, nor any new mates.
A pure heart ain't necessarily a pirate's strong point.
Exactly! But Frank here just happened to play Sir Galahad in your tobacco.
And he forgot every line, if I remember correctly.
It's me! It didn't matter if he forgot his lines, as long as he didn't talk. He was the perfect Sir Galahad. He was the epitome of pure and simple soul.
He was simple, all right.
Mr. Smain, I can't.
Sure you can, lad. He'd be our only hope. I'd be liking this idea, Mr. Smee's here. Tain't no doubt that me and me mates be sharpy. We'd be having a fight with the lily white hearts. What? We'd just be high below decks with our light little hearts while ye conquer the blasted zombies.
But...
And if you succeed, I'll let you jump port.
But what if I don't succeed? I've never actually met a zombie before. I wouldn't know what to do. I wouldn't know what to say.
Just say you're the noble Captain Frank, with a pure heart and honorable manner.
That be the ticket, me bucko!
So ho, Captain, the black mark be coming!
This be it, me mates. All hands below decks!
Aye, Captain.
Here be me cutlass, mate. I not be knowing if it can cut a zombie down. But it be all I can give you. Good luck be with ye.
Just remember all your things you had to go show you, Frank. Chin up. Shoulders back. Ice clear. Become the seafaring Galahad, the noble Captain Frank. We fight for the honorable and the just. We believe in you, Frank. We believe.
I believe we're all crazy to rely on Frank to save us.
I am the noble Captain Galahad. I mean Frank. I fight for the horticultural. No. I fight for the... R.
Davy Jones, anyway, and why is he keeping ho-hos in his locker?
What are you doing here? Where are the actors that are supposed to be doing this?
They're busy fighting over who ate the last ho-ho. So the stage manager said I could take over. And what is all this about ho-hos, anyway? Don't people know they're full of preservatives and are sure to give you high cholesterol?
Never mind. Just get on with your part.
Sure thing. Spider-Man to the rescue. The Adventures of the Fearsome Pirate Frank.
Part the last!
We really have reached a new low. So poor Frank was called to save everyone on the ship from the zombie horde.
He did not look too happy as the black mark pulled abreast, before he was able to look over to the empty eyes of the zombie captain Ben.
Oh dear. I need to hide somewhere. These zombies don't look especially friendly. I need to hide somewhere. This one more.
Oh, her. She's not here right now.
But if you'd like to leave a message.
Answer me, mate, or I'll be sucking out your soul.
Frank! Oh. I be the noble pirate Frank!
The noble pirate Frank! The noble pirate Frank!
What be the meaning of this? I be following the fearsome pirate Frank, lo these many days, and I know this be her ship.
Well, this be her ship, but...
Well then, show me, sir. I be planning to send Frank and all her evil mates to the briny deep where the fish will peck out their eyes and the eels will be eating the black hearts.
Black hearts? Tis true that the fearsome pirate Frank and her crew had black hearts, so I threw her in the briny deep myself, she and all her evil mates.
What? He had no right.
No right.
Frank be mine for the taking. She be mine for exacting me revenge.
Revenge.
He took what be mine, so now he take what be yours. Your life.
Oh dear, this isn't going too well.
Frank.
I mean the noble pirate Frank. I fight for all that is honorable and just.
Honor. Justice. Arr.
Hold your tongue, dog. We not be meaning to hear such talk before we throw your entrails to the sharks. Get him!
Get away from me! You only play on black deeds and black hearts. May heart be pure. May cause be just.
Arr. His heart be pure. His heart be pure. Arr.
Now you gotta break. Bravo, bravo. A pure heart? We be seeing about that. Curses! This not be fair.
What be not fair, Captain? Now, if you don't mind, I think I be rid of the chivalry bull zombies. For honor and justice.
Show. I want to be a pirate.
A pirate?
Of course, Esmeralda has to get a word in. Don't worry, Smee. I'll step in to take the lead. I'd be better than Frank anyway.
Esmeralda, you're not right for the part. If I'm to have a woman play the part, I need someone to play as a fearsome pirate captain. Someone strong and ruthless, yet sleek and sultry. Someone who can strike terror into the hearts of her fellows while she bully and trance them with their feminine wiles. This is a reality show, after all. So I need a real pirate queen.
Now I wonder who that can be.
I'll do it, me bucko. After all this worrying about the black mark, I'd be needing to change my occupation. I think being an actress be suiting me just fine. I'd be liking all the pretty clothes and makeup, long as I can still be the fearsome female I be. No!
And so Frank became the captain of a real pirate ship,
where he was happier than he'd ever been in his life, sailing the seven seas and flying the Jolly Roger.
Yard starboard, my honey! Yard starboard!
And
And the real fearsome part, Frank became the lead in the new hit show,
Shanghaied by the Fearsome Pirate Queen.
The Fearsome Pirate Queen. The Fearsome Pirate Queen. Beyond compare, a swashbuckling maid who is never afraid, a strong and brave corsair. She sails the Jolly Roger and preys on ships at sea. She steals your gold, though we are told she'll invite you back for tea. I'll invite you back for tea. Measure for measure,
she's the most impressive
mass. I'm a most